In Final Cut Pro 10, there are many ways to manage your media. The way Final Cut Pro 10 manages media has changed from previous versions of the software. I'm going to jump ahead a bit to explain the new media management features in Final Cut Pro 10.1.2. You can see that I have two libraries here. If you click on this library at the top, you can see all the associated content off to the right inside the browser window. In this case, you can see that I've got one project along with all my organized content inside this single library package. You'll notice that I have the media organized into a series of folders. These folders are called events. It's important to note that a library can live anywhere on a hard drive. To find where a library lives, right-click on it and choose Reveal in Finder. So in this example, you can see this particular library lives on the desktop. It's important to note this library file is a package that contains project information along with managed media. If you are finished working with a particular library, I recommend that you close it. To do this, right-click on a library and choose Close Library from the contextual menu. Closing libraries that you are not using will provide additional system resources for Final Cut Pro 10. Now, if you are launching Final Cut Pro 10 for the first time, you will have one library with an event inside it. It's a good idea to immediately rename your library to something that makes sense to you. Now, when you start out, your library will have a single event. Go ahead and rename the event to match the content that you plan on importing. It is also a good idea to create a series of additional events ahead of time so you can organize your content before you begin editing. To do this, right-click on a library and choose New Event. Then, give each new event a unique name. Now remember, a library can be stored anywhere you like, and it's important to note that if you're launching Final Cut Pro for the first time, the initial library will be located within your user's movie folder on the internal system drive. Again, to demonstrate, you can find the location of a library by right-clicking on it and choosing Reveal in Finder. You can see that the default location of the library is located in the user's movie folder on the internal hard drive. If you have additional hard drive storage, I do not recommend that you store your media on your internal system drive. This is because your internal drive will eventually fill up with media, and you will still need a place to store or archive your content. Now, remember, the library contains your project information along with your managed media. This functionality has led to some confusion because in order to view the raw media from the OS, you need to right-click on the library package to view the files. There is a new feature in Final Cut Pro 10.1.2 that now gives you the ability to ingest or consolidate media to a folder outside of the library package. To demonstrate, I'm going to reopen the library that I closed earlier by navigating to the File menu and choosing Open Library. If you click on an existing library, the Library Properties window will appear. From here, you can choose a folder outside of the library as a storage location for your media. To do this, click on the Modify Settings button. The default location for ingesting or copying media is set to the location of the library package. However, you can change that from this dialog box. In this example, I'll set the storage location for my library to a folder on an external drive. So now, from this point forward, any media ingested into this particular library will go to a folder on the external drive instead of the library package itself. You can also choose to consolidate your media from an entire library into an external folder. To do this, press the Consolidate button. Then press OK. So now, all the media from the library package has been copied into a folder based on the storage location that you've set within the Library Properties window. I could demonstrate this by right-clicking on a clip within the browser window and choosing Reveal File from the contextual menu. You can see that Final Cut Pro 10 is now referencing the media on the external drive instead of the library package. And also, notice how Final Cut Pro organizes the media into folders based on date stamps within the media. Consolidating media to an external drive is useful if you need to share media with someone else. As long as you receive the content back inside the same folder with the same file names, Final Cut Pro will link back to the new files. As a final note, if you choose this method of managing your media, just make sure you keep your library package along with the specified folder that contains the media when archiving an entire project. For other great tips like this, or to enroll in a Final Cut Pro 10 training class, visit geniusdv.com.